I'm Janet Murguía, President and CEO of UnidosUS, formerly known as the National Council of La Raza. We're the largest Hispanic civil rights and advocacy organization in the U.S. For more than 50 years, we have advanced opportunities for the Latino community. We also partner with nearly 300 affiliates, community-based organizations that ensure Latinos and Latinas have more equitable access to our nation's safety net and opportunities. They adapted quickly during the pandemic to respond to human needs by providing emergency food, PPE, access to broadband, and housing support. Affiliates are also culturally competent, trusted intermediaries that remove access barriers by mobilizing Latinos and Latinas to get vaccinated, to keep our economy open, enrolling them in health coverage, and providing housing counseling to prevent eviction and foreclosure. The Select Committee has a critical charge to create a more inclusive and dynamic economy. Even today, the work of Latinos is fueling the country's economic recovery. The Latino community has had a higher than average labor force participation, start businesses at more than double the overall rate, and wield significant purchasing power. Latinas specifically are one of the fastest growing segments of business owners in the United States. Yet, too many structural factors impede our community's fuller contributions. Latinos, and especially Latinas, also work disproportionately in jobs with very low wages. Even when employed full-time, most Latinos fail to receive the benefits of work. More than half Latinos, including 55% of Latino men and 51% of Latina women, are unable to earn a single paid sick day through their jobs. Latinos are also disproportionately excluded from supports due to immigration status and misinformation on eligibility, among other reasons. Such persistent economic disparities hurt the community and our overall economy. Last year, we found that a Latina-headed family has a median net worth of less than a nickel to the dollar of a typical family headed by a white man, and just a tenth of the net worth of the typical family headed by a white woman. Latinos have incredible resilience and fortitude. But I urge you to imagine the contributions they could make to the economy if our community had a fair and equal opportunity to thrive and participate. The moment has never been more critical. Latinos are more likely to die from COVID, less likely to have health insurance, and more likely to struggle to make ends meet. Importantly, the systems that exacerbate inequality and keep Latinos from building wealth can be addressed. As Nelson Mandela said, overcoming poverty is not a gesture of charity, it is an act of justice, and in our case, it's an act in our own economic interests. We offer three critical recommendations. First, Congress must pass the Build Back Better Act. Among other reasons, all children deserve a permanent, fully refundable credit that restores eligibility for those with a tax identification number and provides monthly payments. The 2021 revisions of the CTC give this policy the potential to cut Latino poverty by more than a third. From our affiliates in Florida, like Hispanic Unity, to folks near here in Casa de Maryland in the DC area, our network continues to engage with Latino families to help them receive the transformative investments of the child tax credit. Second, home ownership is the single most powerful strategy for closing the racial and ethnic wealth gap. Congress should provide a down payment assistance and improve the availability of affordable, safe housing. And to enable savings that allow home ownership and financial well-being, Congress should make college education more equitable by investing in completion grants and canceling student loan debt. Third, Congress should provide a path to citizenship for undocumented immigrants. We are currently facing an epic shortage of workers, which is hurting our economy. As Bloomberg Business reported last October, nationwide, there's more than one job opening for every American who wants to work. Immigrants have long been a part of the solution to labor shortages, yet last year, the U.S. saw the lowest levels of international migration in decades. At the same time, an estimated 5.2 million undocumented immigrants are essential workers who allowed us to put food on our tables and care for our sick and vulnerable. Just as we leaned on immigrants to help us weather the pandemic, they are key to our future economic prosperity. We hope these proposals will receive serious consideration, and I look forward to today's discussions on the ways to support the Latino community's inclusion in the nation's economic life. Thank you.